Hello, everyone. It's not just me in the office today, so if you do hear little mumblings around, it's because there's four of us in the office today, which is crazy, because normally it's like either just me or Rochelle or just me. But today we have our new SEL coordinator, Ashton, in, and we also have Michelle and Ken in the office. Ken just got back from Boost, so that's exciting. Welcome. Nobody's in here with me yet, but I like to say welcome to you guys. Today we're doing observing clouds because it's gorgeous outside. So I'm gonna give it a few minutes and then I'm gonna do some announcements. And then we're gonna breeze through the activity. Breeze, pun intended. And we're probably gonna go outside for a little bit, so I'm gonna look a little insane. I lost my train of thought. I'm gonna look a little insane, like wandering around with the iPad, chatting to it. It's gonna be like one of those influencers in the wild things, although I'm not an influencer, but you know, we all try our best. All right, so some announcements. We have, a very special Fun Friday end of the year celebration. We are calling it our first annual Fun for the Field Resource Fair. If you are a vendor and you would like to take part in the resource fair and be a vendor and have a booth and do all of that, please email me. My email is swashington, like George Washington, the president, swashington@ctncy.org. So if you want to be a vendor, hit me up, let me know, and I'll send you the vendor form information and all that stuff. If you are not a vendor, but you are looking for vendors and you want to go to our resource fair, go ahead and go to our website and register for it. We're going to have lots of cool things. There's going to be a passport book for you guys to complete so that you can win some cool stuff. We're going to have a tie-dye booth. There's going to be some live music. Food will be there. It's May 19th with a rain date of June 2nd, and it is from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., and you can come anytime between those hours, and it's just kind of a way for you to blow off some steam and have some fun, but also meet some really cool vendors and people and find some resources that you can use in your program. I think that's all we have kind of going on right now. At least as far as I know. I could be wrong though. It is a Monday, and it's the first Monday of the month. So yeah. But if I think of anything, I will let you guys know. Don't forget about our Mizzen giveaway. Since today is our final live Mizzen Monday, what I'll do is, I'm not going to say at the end of this month because I'm going on my honeymoon in a few weeks. But after Memorial Day, I will get back. I will go on Facebook. I'll look through all the shares, likes, comments, all of that stuff. And then I will pick a winner. And you guys will get some activity printouts along with some activity materials to do in your program. So that's super exciting. Okay, it's 12:04. I believe I've done all of my announcements because I think that's really kind of all we've got going right now. We are trying to figure out better ways to support you guys as far as professional development and resources that you need. So if you like these, please let me know. Because even though this is the last one of this school year, I would love to do them again next year. But say if you don't want activities and you'd rather maybe talking about something else, I would totally do that if more of you would watch them. So yeah. I think that's everything. So I think we're gonna hop right into our activity. So you remember 2 weeks ago when we had our rescheduled Mizzen Monday, I said that I really wanted to do the cloud thing, but then I couldn't because it was raining. And then what did we do? We drew things. We did scientific sketches, right? These are my scientific sketches. But, so today, as I showed you guys, it's absolutely beautiful out. So we're going to do clouds today. And I'm really excited, but also I'm a little nervous because it is a little chilly outside. So I'll probably bring my shawl too, just in case. Okay. Today we are observing clouds. This is put on the app, on the Mizzen app. I have my little Mizzen printout that I printed out for my phone. This was published by the National Wildlife Federation. And here's just a little description. Clouds are a familiar part of our human environment. Clouds affect our daily plans, and even children pay attention to them from a young age because of the many shapes they can take. Clouds are a key factor influencing local weather as well as the Earth's climate system. They affect the temperature and energy balance of the Earth and play a significant role in controlling the planet's long-term climate. By observing clouds, we can get information about temperature, moisture, and wind conditions at different heights in the atmosphere. This information helps in predicting the weather. Observations of clouds also help us know how much sunlight reaches the ground and how easily heat from the ground and lower atmosphere can escape to space. Clouds play a central role in controlling the exchange of heat in the atmosphere, and changes in clouds over time can have significant climate impacts. This activity is said to take about 50 minutes. It's geared towards grades 1 through 6, and its learning objectives are to record weather observations, to collect, record, and sketch cloud observations. It also says make a cloud viewer, but like I said the last time, some of these Mizzen activities are missing parts, in my opinion. That's not in my opinion, that's like, they're missing things. Like, it says things will be in there, and then you look for them, and then it's not there. But most of them you can use the full activity, and you don't necessarily need the other materials. But it is a little annoying, because it said that you could make a cloud viewer. But I tried to Google what a cloud viewer was, and it was more difficult than I needed to make it. So here we are. So those are our learning objectives. Now we're going to go into our materials. It says you need a clipboard, and I did not bring my clipboard from home. But I do have this fancy little notepad situation. So I'm just going to use this as my clipboard. You could also feasibly have them use their science notebooks, but whatever works. If you don't have enough clipboards for everyone, you know, or if you have like access to those dry erase boards, those work really well as clipboards too. And normally they're, especially in an elementary school, they have them. A pencil, so I have my little trusty pencil. This is my favorite pencil I have. It says scissors, packing tape, and a tongue depressor, but I'm pretty sure those are all because they want you to make the cloud viewer, which we don't have instructions for, so we won't be doing that. Okay, it provides you with some worksheets. The worksheets we'll be using today are the Observing Clouds worksheet. This is a cool little printout. It has like a little box for where you put like the weather for the day, and then it has like the different sections where you're going to mark like what types of, is the sky clear, what color is it, those sort of things. And then we have the globe cloud chart. So this just kind of, you can't see because, hold on, let me try to put this on. There you go. So you have like the sky color, sky visibility, and then on the back, it shows you different types of clouds. So like these are high level clouds, and then we have mid level clouds and low level clouds, and then low level precipitating clouds. We won't have to find any of these today because there's no precipitation. Thank the Lord. Okay, so those are some worksheets. There is a video that you would show your kids. If you were doing that with them, it is the Why Observe Clouds video. It just kind of tells you a little bit about clouds and the importance of the importance of observing them and how if you do this, you can put your data in to their little globe program. And it's like you supplying data for them so that they can learn more about the weather. To prep, it says gather materials, and then to watch the video. I watched the video this morning. Okay, so now we're gonna hop into it. It says we're in the activity steps part. If you're familiar with when I do these, I generally go through the printout the way it goes, and I almost verbatim read everything to you guys. Okay, so it says activity steps inside, get started. You and or your children will need to check a local weather app. It says make sure to do this before you go outside, in a way. So we're going to check our weather app, and we're going to fill out this little box. Okay? So, we're going to use our pencil, just in case, you know. Today's date is May 1st. Oh, also, it's Ken's birthday. If you know Ken, tell him happy birthday. Post it on Facebook or something, or maybe send him a little message. Maybe email him. Today's his birthday. So, yeah, happy birthday, Ken. There you go. Today's date, May 1st. 5-1, the time, we're gonna, oh, 12-12. I didn't have to pick up my phone. 12:12 p.m. And then location, I am in Hartford, Connecticut. Okay, describe the weather. Now I'm gonna grab my phone because we need to look at the weather app. Weather. Okay. Ooh, 58 degrees. I could really use it. I could really, you know, benefit from it being warmer. Anyways, okay, so it says in the describe the weather, it has little blanks, and it has a Fahrenheit thing. So we're going to put 58 degrees. Oh, this has me in Bloomfield. Hold on. Let me put myself in Hartford. Okay. I'm just going to have you guys verify I'm in the right space, Hartford. Okay, so it's 59 degrees. It's the sun is out. It says sunny, partly cloudy, windy, raining, snowing, no precipitation. I'm going to say it's partly cloudy. I wouldn't really say it. Like, it is sunny-ish. We're going to check off the sunny. We're going to put an X where it says cloudy and wind. It's a little windy. I don't know. Maybe we'll wait to mark off the windy thing until we go outside. It's not raining. And it's most definitely not snowing. Thank the Lord. And then as far as I know, no precipitation. So all I did was I just put little check marks on the things that we have, and the little X marks on the things that we didn't. Okay, so now that we have done the inside part and we have recorded the weather, the next thing you would do is set boundaries, provide safety guidelines, and set expectations for outside investigations. So, for instance, this is where you would tell your children, we're staying in the field between these trees, or we will only be staying within the playscape fences. Or this is where you tell them where they can and cannot go, so that when they do go where they're not supposed to, you have already told them and made it explicitly clear, and you know they can't hold it against you. You're going to give each child a handout, a clipboard, and a pencil. Excuse me. And I would work through the weather data with them. What I would do is I would pull it up, like if you have a screen, or say, like if you don't have access to a screen, right, and you only have your phone and some chart paper, kind of recreate this little square on a chart and do it with them. Because then it kind of gets them invested and, you know, gets them really into it. All right, and then it says give each child a globe cloud chart. And yeah, we're gonna go outside. It says when you go outside, you need to put the children together and make them make bees with their arms, but it doesn't really explain what that does or how that helps you. So we're not gonna do that. Plus, there's only one of me. But I am gonna go outside now, so this will be interesting. And we're gonna take a look at some clouds. We're gonna go through step by step all these things. So let's see how this goes. This is in a YouTube video where they would be like, cut, and then you wouldn't see any of the behind the scenes, like how I get you off the Pivo, and me like getting all my stuff together to carry it out while also interacting with you all on the iPad. So just enjoy this. Okay, so I have my activity thing, I have my worksheet, and I have my chart. We have all the things that we need. I think my foot's asleep, but that's okay. We're gonna hope for the best. I also have my sunglasses, so we're gonna put those on. Whoa. And then we're gonna head outside. Okay. All right. We're gonna put that there. Hello. All right. I'm gonna undo you guys. See, this is exactly why. Hello. Okay. Oh, there we go. I was doing it wrong. Okay. Look at how big my head is. Okay. Are you all ready? Are you all ready for this? Oh, let me make sure I have my keys. Okay. Where are my keys? Here they are. And I'm gonna bring my shawl because I need to like put you guys somewhere. There we go. I'm gonna bring my shawl just in case it's a little cold outside. I'm also gonna put on some chapstick because, you know, it gets dry. Oh, the sun just went away. Guys, if it's too cold outside, I'm coming right back in. Just letting you all know. Okay. All right, are we ready? I'm gonna grab this just in case. Uh-oh. And my shawl, because it's cold outside. I have my keys, I have my thing, and I have my thing. Okay, come with me. Let's go. Let's go learn about clouds. Look, see, there's Ken. Okay, we're in the lobby. The FedEx man is here. Okay, here we go. Oh, it's a little chilly. Okay, we're gonna go somewhere where there's no trees. Gosh, my head is really big. There's a dog over there. Where can we go? Where there are no trees. There's a little, bird right there. Look. You want to see him? Look at the little bird. Okay. Anyways, here we go. We're going to go right here because this seems like a good idea. I'm going to be quiet for a few minutes and put you guys down so that you can see the sky and the trees. And I am just going to give you like a few silent minutes, you know, just some mindful minutes where you can just hear the birds tweeting, and then I'll get to talking about clouds, and then we'll go inside. So here's like 3 minutes of just wind and clouds and bird noises.
seems a long 2 minutes. Okay, I apologize for the FedEx truck. I'm gonna pop you up now that you got to see some of the clouds and the trees, and we're gonna hop right into it. I did not bring out the Pivo, which I probably should have. It's, the Pivo is like this little stand thing that we use. But okay, I'm gonna move you so that I can pop you up somewhere. I'm sure that annoying, obnoxious little beeping was not nice for your little mind, wasn't it? Okay. I'm gonna prop you up right here. Ah! Okay, there we go. Okay, are we ready? This is probably the most fun I've had doing one of these. Okay, so first it asks about the sky color, which we have a little thing right here. Different sky colors. Based off what I can see, where's my pencil? Did I not bring my pencil out? I didn't bring my pencil out, but that's okay. I have a pen, so I'm gonna use that one. So the options are deep blue, blue, light blue, pale blue, and milky. We're gonna go with deep blue and blue just because, you know, sometimes. So once again, I'm just like checking them off here. Now that I'm closer to you guys, I can show you things. It's a little windy. So that's like the record the weather box. And then we're doing this part. Sky color. Okay. Ooh, don't lose our little cloud chart sheet. That would be bad. I am gonna put a little check mark next to windy because it is kind of a little windy out here. Now we move on to sky visibility. There's unusually clear and clear, and then somewhat hazy, very hazy. So that's on the bottom right here. See? I'm gonna do clear. I wouldn't say it's unusually clear. Almost losing my paper. Okay. Let's move on to high level clouds. So those are, this is why you bring your keys and things, because then you can, it's like paperweights. So now the high level clouds are these ones, which I don't think we saw any of these. Or even like the cirrocumulus, definitely not the cirrostratus, which is this one. I think we, there is some of this though. There is some of that. Here, do you want to see? Let me show you the clouds. So I'm gonna say there's a little bit of cirrus in the high level clouds. And then we're going to move to mid-level clouds, which are these ones. These two over here. And definitely not altostratus, which is this one. They're definitely more bubbly and cloudy like that. So I'm going to select the altocumulus. And we don't have any... So the last one would be low-level clouds, because there are precipitating clouds, but we don't have any precipitation. So I don't really think, like, we won't see any precipitous clouds. But low-level clouds, let's take a look at what we got here. So we have cumulus clouds, stratus clouds, and stratus cumulus clouds. Let's take a look again. Let's see what we're seeing. I think they're cumulus, because stratocumulus seems a little here. You want to take a look? There we are. Where's my little finger? There we are. These seem like it would be more hazy. This one definitely is given like what the sky looks like right now sort of vibes. So, okay. So I'm gonna mark that off. And then I'll show you guys what I got. And then we'll go back inside. Yeah, it might be a short one today, but it's okay. Can all be long ones. And it's the final one. Okay, so here's what we're working with. Let me take my sunglasses off so I can see. Actually, that doesn't help. Okay, so we have our sky color was, where's my finger? There we go. There's my finger. Deep blue and blue. Our visibility was clear. We saw some cirrus clouds in the high level. We saw some autocumulus clouds in the mid level, and we saw some cumulus clouds in the low level. And then we have all of our wonderful, cool little weather data. So yeah, this was a lot of fun. Actually, I was visiting a program in Manchester last week, and they said that they did this activity with their kids, that they had a lot of fun, and they liked that they had the worksheets, and it made it really easy for them to get it done. So, we're gonna head back inside so I can stop looking like a fool in the middle of the Nonprofit Alliance courtyard. And we'll finish up for today. Oh boy. All right, are you ready? Let's go. Oh, I threw my back out on Friday, so y'all are lucky I could just get off the ground like that. Really lucky. Here we go. Going back in. It still hurts to walk a little, but that's okay. Come with me. Cool beans. Unfortunately, in this lesson, there are no like guiding questions for the end, which is kind of weird because normally it kind of gives you like, normally in almost everyone, it has like ending, like, here's some questions to ask, to reflect. Great, but not today. Okay. All right, here we go. This is a bad angle. We're back. Here, hold on. Oh, they're talking. They're talking. All right, nothing, don't worry. We're back in my office. I'm gonna take these off. Okay, that was a lot of fun. Honestly, it was nice to get outside. Okay, I'm gonna hook you guys back up. Wrong thing. There we go. I think I gotcha. Okay. And then we're gonna move you. Alright. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I learned a lot about clouds. And honestly, I had a lot of fun doing this series. I know it doesn't always get a lot of views, but I really like doing activities with you guys. I especially like when I go to a site and they tell me that they use them as an app, because I'm like, yes, it's good. Use the resource that's free for you, that literally gives you everything you need.
So yeah, and I would recommend this. This was a lot of fun. It's very simple. The kids will like it. First-hand experience, I understand that, is based off what I heard from a program who actually did this. So yeah, here we go. I'm gonna add it to my little science notebook. Yeah, and I really like this activity. Let me just make sure that I'm not missing anything. I don't think so. I double checked. So yeah, we're a little shorter this week. It's not a full hour. So I apologize for that, but you'll get another half hour of your day back. Yeah. Final announcements. Don't forget about our May Fun for the Field Resource Fair. It's like our Fun Friday, last Fun Friday celebration. If you're a vendor, please message us either via our Facebook or email me, swashington@ctncy.org. The more vendors, the better. If you want to come, register using our website. Like I said, we have a vendor who will be providing live music, and they also do regular programming. We have a few people signed up who are going to do some giveaways. And yeah, it's just supposed to be a lot of fun, just like a no-stress sort of day where you just get to find lots of cool resources and have a lot of fun. So please sign up. If you know any vendors, send them my way. If there's a vendor that you use in your program that you love and they'd like to expand their offerings, please. Yeah. So that's everything from me today. Don't forget to wish Ken a happy birthday. And thank you guys so much for letting me do this every month. I really enjoy it. And if there's something else that you guys want to see, either over the summer or starting for next school year, please let us know. Me, Ken, Khadija, Monica, anybody that you can get their email for, that you have an idea, they will find the right person for it. Just send it their way, because we're trying our best to figure out how to support you guys. And that's the most important part of our job. So yeah, thanks so much, guys. I really had a lot of fun. Bye.